Hello guys, welcome to another video of mine, a very exciting one actually. I'm now in Brisbane, Queensland. I'm about to catch the Spirit of the Outback train to Longreach. The journey to the Outback of Queensland takes roughly 25 hours. I have managed to secure myself a first class twin bed cabin. I can't wait to show you what it looks like, so let's get to the train station now.
The Spirit of the Outback is a two weekly railway service between Brisbane and Longreach. The train departs Brisbane Roma Street Station every Tuesday at 10 past 6pm and Saturday at 1:55pm. It then heads north towards Gympie, Bundaberg, Gladstone and Rockhampton before heading west to Emerald, Alphar, Barcorden and Longreach. The whole trip takes 26 hours. The train set consists of two diesel-hauled locomotives, one luggage car, four first-class carriages, two economy-class carriages, and three lounges for economy and first-class passengers. Before showing you my first-class cabin, I'd like to show you the economy-class carriages. At the front of the carriage, there's a shower room and a luggage rack for suitcases. On the other end of the carriage, there are two toilets. The seats in this carriage are in a 1-2 configuration. All seats face in the direction of travel. The seats provide a good amount of leg room. I could comfortably stretch my legs. The seats also offer a good degree of recline. The second economy class carriage has the same layout, except the seats are in a 2-2 configuration. There is a licensed dining car for economy class passengers, where you can purchase a variety of hot and cold snacks and meals throughout the journey. Following the dining car, there are two lounges that are exclusive to first class passengers. One is called Shearers Rest and the other is called the Tucker Box Restaurant. I'll show you more about them later on during the journey. Now, finally, let's have a look at the first class carriage. Car B, C and D consists of 6 twin sleeper cabins and 2 single sleeper cabins. Car A consists of 9 single sleeper cabins only. Due to COVID-19, Queensland Rail only sells twin sleeper cabins on the service, which means car A is not in use and there are only a total of 18 first class twin cabins available on each service.
My name's Brent and I'll be one of the supervisors throughout your journey to Longreach. Along with the rest of the onboard crew, we would like to welcome you aboard the Spirit of Outback service to Longreach and all intermediate stations.
The first class twin sleeper cabin is in fact two single sleeper cabins without a wall in the middle. The cabins have the exact same layout but in the opposite direction, which means the seats face each other and there's a door on the side of each seat. Due to COVID-19, I have the whole twin cabin to myself. There's a retractable armrest on both sides of the seat. The seat is not reclinable, but it's quite wide, and there's a headrest that perfectly fits my neck. There's a power socket on the side of the wall, a control to adjust the volume of the passenger announcement, a tiny table, a wardrobe to keep my jacket, and a tiny rubbish bin. On the corner of the cabin, there's a mirror and a sink built in the 1980s. Personally, I don't think a sink is necessary in this tiny cabin because there's a toilet and a shower room at the end of the carriage. Instead, I'd prefer to have a wall-mounted drop-leaf table to put my belongings and my suitcase below it. The amenities for first-class passengers include a plastic cup, a soap, a towel, and an amenity kit. In addition, there's a welcome letter for each first-class passenger with the allocated time for your meals written on the envelope. A handbook is also provided to show you the facilities on board and the attractions along our journey to Longreach. When you leave your cabin, the door can be locked using the key provided. There's a toilet and a shower room at the end of each first-class carriage. The toilet has plenty of space with a sink, a hand wash dispenser, and paper towels. The afternoon tea was served just half an hour after train departed Brisbane. Each of us was served with three jam scones on a choice of tea, coffee or water. The Shearers Rest is a lounge area exclusive to first-class passengers. The half-circle booth seating has made it the perfect place to socialise and interact with other fellow passengers and the train staff. About 3.5 hours after we left Brisbane, we arrived at Gympie North Station. The train is scheduled to stop here for 10 minutes, so we are allowed to stretch our legs on the platform. And Gympie North is the northern boundary of the Translink network. It is serviced by two daily city network services towards Brisbane Roma Street. As the sun slowly sets down, I started to feel a bit peckish. My allocated dinner time is still 90 minutes from now, so I decided to order a hot snack from the galley. These are the meals and snacks you can order if you were in the economy class. The wedges and a can of Coke cost $7.50, which I think is a pretty fair price.
Almost 7:30, it's time for dinner.
The first class dining area is located at the iconic Taco Box restaurant. The carriage is well decorated. This is my most expectantly part of this train journey. The meals are included in my first class ticket. Each meal is prepared by the onboard chef using some of Queensland's best produce. For this three-course dinner, you can choose from three main dishes and two desserts. A complimentary drink is also served with the meal. The entree tonight is an oven-baked rosemary damper served with chive butter. The damper is quite warm when served, and the chives in the butter adds a mild, grassy flavour to this dish. For the main course, between vegetarian lasagna, roast pork and steak, I picked the Scotch fillet steak with red wine tea. I also asked for a glass of ceremonial Shiraz as a complimentary drink. The portion of the steak is a bit small, at roughly 150 grams. However, it was cooked beautifully and the side veggies were amazing. For dessert, I picked rich flourless chocolate cake, accompanied by a cup of hot white tea. The chocolate cake was plated perfectly. It also tastes pretty delicious. Overall, I'm very happy with this dinner meal. I finished my dinner at about 8:30, and at the same time, the train arrived at Bundaberg.
Here we go, a day seat transits into a comfortable single bed.
Just as expected, the bed was made by the staff while I was having dinner. The space in the cabin became even smaller once the bed was put down. There's a quilt and two pillows for each bed. The mattress is pretty soft, the bed is actually quite comfortable.
I'm glad I'm skinny. Oh.
There are a limited number of tablets you can borrow from the train staff. You can watch movies, TV shows, music, and a safety video about the train on the tablet. The movie choices are a bit limited, but it's great that Queensland Rail offers this service.
So I just had a delicious dinner and the bed was made by the staff. It's time to sleep. See you in the morning. Good night. Good morning, guys. It's now almost 6 o'clock. I just woke up. My sleep overall was fine. I think I woke up only once to put up a layer of clothes because the aircon was a bit cold. The bed was comfortable, it was okay. And overall, I think I had a pretty decent sleep. Now it's time to have a shower.
The shower room is situated opposite to the toilet at the end of the carriage. There's a shower curtain in the middle of the room, so there is space for you to put your towel and clean clothes.
So I just had my first ever shower on a train. The water pressure was pretty good. The water was hot as well. The only thing is there's no shampoo provided, so you better bring your own. But otherwise, it's a very comfortable shower. Now let's get ready for breakfast.
As the train was traveling at a maximum speed of 100 kilometers per hour towards Outback Queensland while I was sleeping, the landscape outside the window is completely different to what it was like before I went to sleep. Cities have disappeared, so are the forests. Instead, it was replaced by endless bush and farmlands. The breakfast, again, takes place at Tuckerbox restaurant, prepared by the onboard chef using locally sourced Queensland ingredients. I again asked for a cup of white tea to start my day. For breakfast, I get to choose between a hot breakfast or continental breakfast. Just like most other passengers, I picked the hot breakfast. The omelette was cooked perfectly. For about an hour, the train was slowly climbing over the Drummond Range section. At around 10 o'clock, we arrived at Alpha Station. The train is scheduled to stop here for 10 minutes, so we get a chance to have a look around the town.
Wow, that service, thank you so much. Thank you.
In the 2016 census, Alpha had a population of 335 people. The town was initially established as a temporary terminus during construction of the Central Western Railway line. After the completion of the line in 1884, the construction camp continued moving west, but the township remained at the former terminus. Until 1990, Queensland Rail maintained a locomotive depot in the town. At 140 kilometers west of Alpha is Barcorden. The train arrived here just after 1 o'clock in the afternoon. The most famous landmark in Barcorden has to be the Tree of Knowledge, situated right in front of the train station. The tree with a 200-year-old ghost gum, it symbolizes the foundation of the organized representation of labor in Queensland. The town was the headquarters of the 1891 Australian Shearers strike, and the tree was the site of the 1892 reading of the Labour Party manifesto, leading to the formation of the Australian Labour Party. Unfortunately, the tree was poisoned and killed in 2006. It is now a place of inspiration, reflection, and celebration, preserved and placed under an award-winning timber structure. After returning onto the train, it's time for the last meal on this journey. The two-course lunch meal includes a main and a dessert dish.
That sounds good.
For the main course, I picked Queensland Bush lemon and pepper barramundi. The fish was really fresh, flavoursome, and cooked really well. This is the most delicious dish I have had on this train. I would highly recommend you to try this dish for lunch. For dessert, I picked lightly sliced poached pears, finishing with another cup of white tea. The pears, cinnamon, cardamom, citrus, and sugar syrup all worked perfectly with each other, making it a super yummy dessert.
We are currently running pretty close to our timetable, with an expected arrival time into Longreach at approximately 3:45.
This 26-hour train journey to Longreach has totally exceeded my expectations. All the staff on board are so friendly and love their job. The four meals I had on board were so delicious. The three lounges on board give me plenty of space to look around, relax, and make friends. The twin cabin is lockable, which gives me the privacy I wanted at night time. The shower facility enables me to get off the train fully refreshed. There are a few minor problems with the design of the cabin. For example, the room is too small to store any luggage, and there isn't a table to place my laptop. But in general, the journey is way worth than what I paid for. I would give this train experience a 9 out of 10. Queensland Rail is currently running a promotion on this service. If you think the GAN and Indian Pacific service are too pricey, yet you would like to experience an overnight train journey in Australia, I would highly recommend you to try out this service. Thank you so much for watching this video. Welcome to Longreach, the gateway to Queensland's outback and the place where Qantas Airways grew up. If you find this video interesting, please don't forget to give it a like. In a few days' time, I will be travelling on New South Wales train link XBT First Class Sleeper from Sydney to Melbourne. If you would like to be the first to watch the video, then please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I'd like to wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
and I'll see you guys in my next video.